And then I had another request. Well, it wasn't a request, crepe, it was like a book. I'm making a joke. It was a lot of valid questions. And username, what I gotta read it because it's so Lass Pitchker. Lass Pitchker. What the hell? Kind of a you. I thought, you know, come on. Get like a. I want an explanation on the username. That'll be the pay for doing this. Okay, he had like a million questions. I have to look at the list. Okay. Here we'll do like a traveling camera thing. Look at it, it's moving. I hope I don't drop it on the ground. Hold on. Just jig it up there a bit. Oh, my camera mount failed. Stand by. Are you nervous? I'm gonna fix your guitar. Are you nervous? Are you nervous? Okay, the first, I think it was like three questions he had. And the first one was all about he's going to start doing some fret work and stuff and wants to level his frets and do the crowning and all that stuff. I'll only say this much. If it's your own guitar and you really love it, don't make that the first guitar you try to do fret work on. It's not, you know. You gotta do it a few times, you know. And well, I could tell a story here, but I don't want to make it like turn into a freaking novel. So I'm gonna think about what I'm gonna tell you about how I learned, and then you can decide what you want to do. I gotta think this out. Hold on, just a sec. Probably 25 years ago or more, a band I was in, we rehearsed below. A guy that was a custom builder, custom guitar builder and repairman. And I always had time to kill after college, waiting for the other guys to show up for rehearsal. So I'd go hang out. And he'd let me sit and watch. And I asked a lot of questions. And he was a bass player too. And I was studying electronics. And he was an electronic guy as well. He was a guitar repairman as well as a builder. And so I sat there probably for, oh, I guess probably 30, maybe 40 days over the course of time, and just sat there and watched what he did and asked about the tools and why he was doing things, and he was very gracious. And that's really how I learned. I watched another guy do it a whole bunch of times, and that was a bonus. If you don't have that, you know. Ability to sit and watch somebody, watch the videos. I've done a bunch. And once again, there's many ways to skin a cat. So keep that in mind, and I'll think a little more about what I'm going to talk about with the fretwork thing. Okay, maybe a little bit more about fretwork. What? Oh, I know in my videos that you see me do it, but each fret level job is. You know, they're all a little different, and it's not like grinding down a, you know, a 2x4. It requires a little finesse. So, like I said, if it's your own guitar and it's your favorite guitar, I don't know if you want to go there. If you've only got a couple of guitars and you're going to go start buying tools, I don't know if it's worth spending that money if you've only got a couple of guitars. You shouldn't be leveling your frets and doing all that kind of stuff. That's like something that happens after 4 or 5 years. If you look back at some of my videos, the better guitars that I've worked on, you know, they've had 4 or 5 years of service, and they'll go another 4 or 5 years. And if you maintain them, it'll probably go 15, 20 years, maybe a lifetime, if the frets are of good quality. So, guys, gals, the fret thing. Good luck. Don't waste your money, and don't wreck your guitar. Cheers. Yes, I think I just came up with the title for this new segment. This will be called "Don't Wreck Your Guitar." Okay, this is "Don't Wreck Your Guitar," episode 1.2, fretboard damage. Let's just look at that. Okay, so I'm going to assume it's a rosewood fretboard. Maybe you said that. in the thing, but I can't remember paying attention. So, yeah. Okay. If it's missing material, if there's a chip, a chunk right out of it, that's repair number one. But if it's just severely dented, that's the other repair. So let's go with the severe dent. If you look back at some of my other videos where I steamed out, where I used a wet rag and put the soldering pencil on there and steamed it, that'll work on a rosewood fretboard. You can get a dent out of a fretboard by steaming it up. Okay, that's remedy one. If there's actually a chunk or a chip missing, I'll show you what could be done. Hold on. Well, first of all, if we want to do this and make it look acceptable, we're going to need another piece of rosewood. Where you get that, I can only guess. I'm lucky I got a bunch of crap and junk laying around from a bunch of other guitars and repairs. So you can see, I'd sacrifice that to fix my nice Fender guitar, or, you know. These aren't very expensive. You can get them 10, 12 bucks, but you know, you gotta find something that's close. Maybe, you know, like a guy who's got like a wood shop or something, right? This is one that was crap, so I could grind some of that up. So we'd sand that up and make a bunch of dust and make a powder. And we're gonna make our own fill that's gonna go in the dent. And once again, I'd have to, you know, see what's wrecked and try and, you know, figure out what I can do. Okay, so we could steam it out if it's just a dent, but if it's got a chip or a chunk missing, then we'd have to make some dust. Then we could take white glue and we mix it with the dust and we work it in. And then afterwards, you know, you might take more than one pass, and then we'd tape off the frets and we'd get in there and we level it nicely, and it might not look perfect, but it will look better, and it will, the guitar will function. So, you know, that's about the best we can do sometimes. We can't always not make them perfect, but we can always make them better. And last, but not the most retarded request I've ever had, it's about installing a pre-slotted nut, and what the deal is with that. Hold on, I will explain. Well, pre-slotted is exactly what it means. It's pre-slotted. We shouldn't have to take too much material off in the slots themselves. Those may need to be tweaked slightly. To adjust the height, we sand material off the bottom. So to answer that little question about where do you take stuff off, you take it off the bottom. And afterwards, after you've strung it up, you may have to adjust individual strings depending on the gauges of strings you use. But usually they're pretty good. If you get the better quality ones, they're not bad at all. Okay, that's it for last pitchker. I'm gonna, my jaw hurts saying that. Anyway, cheers, folks. Video requests, repair requests. Have a nice weekend.